we got so many requests from the students regarding the analysis of previous year UGC-net question papers. I know there's a lot of analysis which is available for GATE question papers out there. Every now and then, people are giving analysis of GATE question papers because the number of students who are giving the GATE examination is a lot more than the number of students who are giving UGC-net examination. But it is very crucial for UGC-net examination for, as this analysis is not done by anyone till now. And what we have done is, in my team, our team took around last 10 year question papers, and then they found out that it is better to take analysis of last 6 year question papers for the UGC-net. So this kind of analysis we have done for paper 2 as well as for the paper 3. So here you can see this is a paper 2 analysis which is covering the July 2016 paper, August 2016 question paper, June, December, January, June again which is 2014, December 2014 question paper. They have seen what is the number of questions they have asked from various subjects, and accordingly found out what are the subjects which are the most crucial. Now, we have only 2 months which is left for the UGC-net examination. Now, if you want to qualify UGC-net examination, it is not necessary that you have to study all the subjects, right? See, knowledge of every subject is mandatory because UGC-net exam is totally based on the width of the number of subjects that you are going to cover. This is a very small difference with the GATE examination. In GATE, we mostly work on depth of each subject. That is, the quality of question that is asked in GATE is much better as compared to the quality of questions that are asked in UGC-net examination. In GATE, we have 10 to 12 subjects, and all those from all those subjects, the kind of questions they are asking are very much in depth. But in UGC-net examination, obviously, the theory part is exactly the same because no one can change the theory part. The only thing that is differing is about the question, the kind of question that is coming. For the UGC-net examination, students who have done masters, they are eligible. Either it can be M.Tech, MCA, MSc. Let us suppose it is computer science, then it can be M.Tech, computer science, MSc, IT or MCA. Now here you can see what are the subjects that are coming in UGC-net examination. So let me mark out the subject which are also there in GATE examination as well as for UGC-net. So this digital logic subject is there in GATE as well as UGC-net. Algorithm and programming data structures is in GATE as well as UGC-net. Theory of computation is also in GATE. Operating system is also in GATE, computer architecture is also in GATE, compiler design is also in GATE, DBMS, computer networks, discrete mathematics, they are in GATE examination. Then we have mathematics and linear algebra. So these subjects which are in data mining, software engineering, Unix, OOPS and C++, these subjects are not present in the GATE examination. Now out of all these subjects, you can see in case of GATE, we have engineering mathematics, which is in more in depth as compared to UGC-net examination, because in UGC-net we have linear programming which is there. Okay, now these are the subjects which is data mining, software engineering, Unix and OOPS and C++ which are not present in GATE examination. Okay, now we'll see the analysis of each and every question paper. Like this is a question paper of July 2016. In July 2016, out of 50 questions, because every this is about the paper 2 analysis, right? So we are going to make an analysis for paper 2 as well as for the paper 3. So in case of paper 2 analysis, we have approximately 50 questions in paper 2. And this is July 2016 analysis, which is saying that after 50, 5 questions are from digital logic, which is approximately somewhere around 10%. For algorithm programming data structures, which is 8 questions, we have theory of computation. And you can see the number of questions which is asked in each of these subjects. Like theory of computation, it is having very small weightage or very less weightage in all of these examinations. So theory of computation you can ignore for paper 2. Okay, so we will do a separate analysis for paper 3. So this is just, it is going to lay out a plan for you that what are the subjects that you should focus on more so that you can get a good rank in UGC-net. Then we have operating system. You can see the number of marks is 5, 5, 3, 6, 5, 5 and so on. Then we have computer architecture. For paper 2, computer architecture is very less, but for paper 3, they are asking a lot of questions on computer architecture. But in paper 2, you can see the total number of percentage, that is around 2% of the questions are from paper 2 only. Okay, so what we have done is we have taken all these numbers, that is for comparison, how many questions asked in which year. For DBMS, how many questions asked in which year? For discrete, how many questions asked and so on. Now, out of our analysis, we found out what is the total number of questions asked in last 6 years for each subject. Now, for example, digital logic, in last 6 years, we have total of 18 questions. From algorithm and programming data structures, a total of 47 questions are asked. Then for operating system, we have 29 questions. Then for compiler design, we have 17 questions. For DBMS, we have 32 questions. For computer networks, we have 33 questions. For discrete mathematics, we have 35 questions. Now, in the same way, we have software engineering, which is covering around 29 questions. Then we have about software engineering. Then we have Unix, which is covering 5 questions. Then we have OOPS and C++, which is covering 16 questions, and so on. Now, in all these analyses, we found out that the subjects which are having more percentage as compared to other subjects. But, I mean, the subject which is having more importance which is more than 10%. Now, here for programming and data structures, in paper 2, approximately 15.67% questions are asked from programming and data structures. Then we have for operating system, approximately 10% questions are from operating system. That is around 9.67%. Then for DBMS, we have 10.67% questions are from DBMS. Then computer networks is around 11%. Discrete mathematics is again 11.67%. And software engineering is again 9.67%. Now, if you want to ask me, what are the subjects can we leave for paper 2? Okay, for paper 2, you can leave the subject Unix. Because the number of questions asked from Unix is around 2% only. And the kind of question they are going to ask is, I mean, most of the time it is hard. Because the kind of queries they are going to ask, it is sometimes you will not be able to answer it. But then, for mathematics, there is real programming here for paper 2, it is 3.33%. So, this is the entire analysis for paper 2 subjects. Now, if you want to ask, sir, I just want to prepare for paper 2. What are the subjects that I should focus on? The simple answer is, do algorithm programming and data structures, then do operating system, then compiler design, DBMS, computer networks. Why I am saying compiler design, even though it is only 6%? Because it is a very small subject. Now, you can take a subject like operating system. In classroom, operating system takes 32 to 40 hours to complete. On average, it is around 40 hours. But compiler design hardly takes 20 hours to complete. So, it is a half of a subject and still proportionately it is covering the number of marks. Now, for DBMS, it is around 11%, which is 10.67, but round off it to 11%. Then for computer networks, it is around 11% and so on. So, the last examination you can see for August 2016, this is the total weightage that you got for each and every subject. Okay, from this you can make a simple analysis for paper 2 of UGC-NET examination. Okay, now we'll come back with the next video, which will be about paper 3 analysis of these subjects. And for paper 3, then we'll try to plan out a strategy that after covering paper 2 and covering paper 3, what are the subjects where you should focus more? And what are the subject which is contained maximum percentage. Now, if you have to score minimum bare minimum marks just to qualify UGC-NET. See, scoring bare minimum marks is not enough. In the same way, scoring minimum marks for GATE is not enough. Like for example, for UGC-NET now, for this November examination, you need at least 40% in paper 1, paper 2, paper 3 to qualify it. But just to qualify it is not going to solve your problems. Okay. In the same way, for GATE examination, you need at least 25 marks out of 100 for computer science to qualify it. But scoring 25 marks out of 100, again, it is not going to solve your problem. Because after this, you are going to have rankings. And according to the rankings, you are going to get colleges. Like for example, for JRF, if you are doing UGC-NET for JRF, you need to be in top 6%. Okay. Now, in the same way, for all these subjects, if these subjects are common for GATE, so this is the reason why the students who are preparing for UGC-NET, they are mostly also preparing for GATE. And that is why the GATE examination is also need to help for UGC-NET examination. So what we have done is, in our courses, we have combined for GATE, both GATE and UGC-NET. The only difference is that about the level of question papers. So we have solved all the question papers of GATE examination as well as we have solved all question papers of UGC-NET examination. And solving all these question papers, then we have taken question papers from other examinations like we have ISRO, DRDO, BARC, and all these examinations. We have taken question papers from them and then we are solving and we are making video solutions of each and every question paper. Okay. And for a future plan, we are also planning to solve question papers from examinations like DSSB or teaching vacancies. Anywhere, wherever you are going to have teaching vacancies for a computer science candidate, we are going to solve those question papers in the next 1 or 2 years. Okay. So, I hope you enjoyed this video and you found this video very helpful. Now, if you found this video very helpful, you want to register for our courses, then you can contact us on the contact number which is given below. Okay. And let us move on to the next video, that is the next part of this video. Okay, all the best.